As per the introduction, my name is Christos Vardikos. I'm a Greek lawyer and I'm also the consul for the Commonwealth of Dominica in Greece. The present presentation will cover both the two jurisdictions. I have heard what the other speakers have said. Apart from being a consul, apart from being an attorney at law, I'm also an authorized agent for the Citizenship by Investment Unit. That means that we are service providers for the program. We have our own office in Dominica. We assist direct clients and agents. Most of our clientele is agents. And for those who follow the presentation today and who want to have a direct access for the Dominica program, they are welcome to contact me. We have an advantage in comparison to other authorized agents. We work at the same time zone with Russia. We have Russian-speaking personnel, and we can organize a meeting in Moscow should the client or the agent wishes. So the presentation is both the jurisdictions. And as Patrick said before, the people who go for a second citizenship are people who want to gain international mobility, they want to have an estate and the tax planning, or they want to have asset protection. If, from my experience all these years, since we practice the citizenship by investment since 2005, and the program of Dominica is since 1993, we have seen all types of clients. First of all, Dominica has never revealed numbers, has never revealed quotas, and has never given details of nationalities or any information whatsoever on the applicants. So to start with, there is a complete secrecy on the process. The second remark that I would make is that we listen from everybody from the Caribbean stating numbers of countries, how many countries you can enter with this passport, how many countries are visa free. I think that this is an argument, but this is not a valid argument. I'm sorry, but we have a problem. My hotel is very cautious on electricity and the hotel room switches off. So the valid argument, it's not a valid argument, as I said. What is the difference if you can travel to more than 150 countries or territories that Dominica permits you? Are you going to visit Tuvalu? Are you going to visit a remote country in Africa? No. You have to see which countries your new country, your adopted country, will give you. Dominica is in a very closed club. It belongs to the five countries in the world that have access to European Union, to England 6 months, as all the Caribbean, but also Singapore and Hong Kong, but also Russia, Ukraine, and China. The Chinese visa-free is a fact. This is to say that the Dominica passport has nothing to envy from Grenada. Up to now, Grenada was the only country in the Caribbean who possessed this valuable visa-free. Dominica is more cost-effective, and presents the same advantages now as Grenada. And for people who are cautious and don't have the American dream and do not dream about an E2 visa, who are very careful over their tax planning, it is an opportunity. That is to say, Dominica, along with Brunei, Seychelles, and Maldives, and Grenada, of course, are one of the five countries in the world that can combine the Russian visa-free, the Chinese visa-free, plus the Schengen and the UK, plus other countries. Dominica has recently signed with Ghana. It has signed diplomatic relations with many countries recently. I'm not allowed to make any sort of announcement. This will be announced by the government shortly. And it is expanding the visa-free. This is for the clients who want to have the international mobility. Now, as far as the tax planning and the estate planning, and why I'm doing the presentation today, Dominica can be combined with a Greek residence permit. A Greek residence permit that I will describe to you the various combinations possible that will give you an EU residency with no tax implications, with non-dom possibility, with applicability of a double tax treaty between Greece and Russia, even for individual entrepreneurs, for a work permit that is immediate, and for a work permit that can be transferred to any other European country. And at the end, if the client wishes and he wants to, he may apply for Greek citizenship if he fulfills certain requirements. That's to say, the combination of the Dominica citizenship in conjunction with a Greek residence permit will give him a powerful passport and a powerful status. He will avoid ETS, and I will explain further down what is ETS, which is coming. It will give him immediate access to the EU. You don't have to wait 5 years for an EU accession, if ever and whenever. And it gives you the possibility for you and your children to grow and live in a European environment with a tax-effective passport and citizenship. Dominica's program has been very effective, and it is a sustainable program. All the speakers say about the government fees and the what you pay to the government. You pay to the government, and the Dominica government has shown that the funds that are being gathered from the program have been leading to housing, have been leading to the construction of a new airport now, and the program is voted for the past 5 years the best citizenship program by the Financial Times. So I will start this technical presentation, for as I suppose that most of you are agents, and I shall be ready to have the any sort of questions that you may have. So I suppose that everybody knows that Dominica is not the Dominican Republic. It's between Martinique and Guadeloupe. As I said, the program exists since 1993. It is variated, and now you can add siblings, and I will explain further down. And the definition of the dependents has been enlarged. Plus, there is a special rate for those who had Dominica citizenship acquired in the past, going to add members of their family who existed and were not included, or who become now members of their family. I talk about spouses and newborn kids. So the Dominica program is the most cost-effective and modulable. As you see on the charts, the initial cost for the main applicant or the single applicant is $100,000. Modulable, that means the spouse is added, it's more $50,000, and every dependent is $25,000. Here the government has made an exception, and should you have a main applicant, a spouse, and two children or two dependents, a child and the parents, and just to clarify, the parent can be the parent from the main applicant or his spouse. Instead of having 200,000, it is 175. The siblings that can be added, it's very simple. They are variated up to 18 years of age and from 18 till 25. The siblings that are below 18 have a government cost of 25,000 and between 18 to 25, 50,000. Also, Dominica was one of the first countries who established the real estate option. The real estate option by law has to be minimum 200,000. At the market currently, it's 220. And along with the investment that you make, you have to make a government contribution, which is a non-refundable contribution, of 25, 35, 50, and 70, as you see on the charts. Of course, if you have a sibling, the sibling has the same fee along with the donation, it's 25 and 50,000. As I said, the dependents have been enlarged. And what means enlarged? This has been, many cases have been clarified. The kids that can be included can be up to the age of 30. The parents, the grandparents, the siblings of the main applicant or of the spouse, the parents of both spouses can be included. And as I said, the siblings have to be single and childless in order to be included to the application. The persons who have, there is no limit for the parents and the grandparents. There was a limit before of 55 years old that has been abolished. So if we have a grandparent who is 45, yes, he can be included in the application. There is no limit, minimum age requirements. So also, if a parent has the sole custody, he can sign by himself the application of a minor child. There is also possibility of having a grandfather having the custody of his of a grandparent having the custody of his grandchild. He can include it in the application, although maybe his son or daughter have passed away, or they have been deprived of the custody of and the guardianship of the custody of their children. Now we come to another sector, the addition of extra dependents. Dominica is very cautious, and they are very family orientated. They wish that even if you have acquired in the year 2000 or in the year 2010 the Dominica citizenship, that you can add your next of kin. So if you were single in 2015 and you acquire the Dominica citizenship, you can add your spouse instead of having a new application at the reduced rate of $75,000 plus the due diligence and other applicable fees. Also, you can include the siblings, both at up to the 25 years of age. Again, you have to pay the due diligence, and for the sibling that should be above, most probably 16, and for the parents. And you have one exception: if you acquire citizenship today, you have the possibility within 1 year to include your next of kin that were not included at the time, with at a reduced rate. Instead of paying $75,000 for your spouse, you pay $50,000, and instead of paying $50,000 for every dependent, you pay $25,000. As I said, Dominica has the real estate option, long time established, and this is the example of a hotel that has been finished and is working in Dominica, in Portsmouth. It's the Kempinski. It is completely, the shares have been completely been sold out. I think that in order to explain to the various agents that in Dominica, the person becomes equity shareholder of this, of the government approved project. That means you are a shareholder, an equity shareholder in a project. So this is a project that has been finished, and you can become shareholder by buying an existing share. It is a state-of-the-art hotel, an excellent hotel. This is another option. It is the Hilton. It is in a very advanced stage, and it's going to be it is in the region between Portsmouth and Roseau. It is a very nice designed hotel, and this is the Secret Bay. The Secret Bay, it's an award-winning boutique hotel. It has villas. You can own your own villa, and you can own a fraction of a villa with the possibility of staying over during the year. The benefits, I'm going to be very brief. First of all, you have secrecy. You have the citizenship for life. You have a dual citizenship that is permitted, or triple citizenship, because Dominica does not restrict you to renounce your current citizenship. You can have many citizenships. It is full and unconditional citizenship. It doesn't give you the condition to visit Dominica. You don't have to visit Dominica. There is the question of language has been waived. English is the official language. And you have also, as I said before, the tax-free status on your worldwide income. So it is very simple: confidentiality, asset protection, your tax optimization. It is very easy to get a US or a Canadian visa. And I will explain further how this can be done. Very quickly, how you can apply. These are the basic application forms. They describe your life A to Z, your financials, your education, and your past. We shall be very happy to give you the forms should someone request it. Apart from that, you have to give criminal records, bank references, bank statements, one bank reference, one professional reference, utility bills, proof of residential address, maybe your army exemption or army service, you need sometimes letters from school for the children, your degrees and diplomas, and most important of all is the source of funds. You have to show that that the funds that are going to be utilized are yours, and you have gained them through your work, through an estate, or through the sale of one asset. Dominica has always been sustainable and has always been advanced. This is a screenshot of the portal that works now 4 years for Dominica, more than 4 years. That means that we as authorized agents, we have access to this portal, we upload the documentation, and upon the payment of the initial fees, with the press of a button, the application can be filed. We have a success rate of getting an approval within 40 to 50 days. And depending how quick you can be in paying your government fee, we can guarantee you that in 20 days from the payment, we can get you your full citizenship with your passport. So, as I said, in this portal, everything is being uploaded. For our agents, if they are bulk in numbers, we grant them access so they can have themselves also use of the portal. So this is the end here. This is the passport of Dominica up to 1978. It was like that. This is copy of the current passport that is valid till July 2023, end of the certificate of naturalization. And now Dominica has installed and inaugurated the biometric passport. Currently, all passports are being recalled and can be replaced, moreover, and can be changed to new passports with 52 pages. 52 pages to have enough place for stamps and back and forth travels. Since the 19th of July, the biometric passports is a reality. They provide security, the booklet has security features and 52 pages. Apart from being a citizen, having a nationality, you can, with a visit in Dominica, you can acquire a driver's license and tax number. And also, in the future, a multi-purpose, the identity card and the social security number. Also, should the client wish to have a utility bill or a bank account, we also can accommodate this need. We work with various serious institutions to minimize the risks of fraud, that it's well known in the ex-CIS countries that people are very cautious about bank establishments. So in order to pass to Greece and to make the transition, this is ETIAS. What is ETIAS? ETIAS is the system that the European Union will have seen from 2022, where the citizen of one of the 63 visa-free countries for the EU, in order to access the EU, he will have to make an application. It will be an application like the American ESTA. You will go online, you will pay $30, and you will get an entry for 3 years for the European Union. You are American, you are Japanese, you are Dominican or Antiguan or Grenadian or Australian, you have to do it. So this is for everybody. How you can come over? Here comes Greece. So Greece is running 4 different programs. It's running the Golden Visa program, the FIP program, the non-DOM, and the program that can be complied with corporate solutions. So the Greek program, the Greek Golden Visa program, can be done. We have seen many Russians who have been buying property here. I'm going to be very brief because this is what most people know it. You have to buy $250,000 euros property in any part of Greece, not like Portugal that you have to buy in the province. Your kid can be the main applicant with a decision of the Supreme Court in Greece. A minor kid can be applicant to for a golden visa. And the golden visa covers the parents, the grandparents, and the kids. It can cover three generations. Now, Greek market is bullish. Greek market is now it is the time to enter in Greece and purchase a property. The prices are still affordable, and there is no capital gains, there is no VAT on the properties. It is very easy to get it. We can do everything remotely. You don't have to come to Greece. We can open the bank account remotely. We can make the contract. We can file the golden visa remotely, and you can come only for the biometrics. Now, if you tackle it with a Dominica passport, your Dominica passport can have on it a European residence permit, and it is the ultimate weapon to travel. You will have a European passport, a European residence visa on your Dominica passport. Anything can be achieved. If you want an American visa, it will be very easy to get it from the American embassy in Greece. The same applies for Australian and for Canadian visa. What is the variation of the golden visa now? We know about the real estate. Greece has installed the possibility to have golden visa with a bank deposit. You don't have to come to Greece. We open for you a bank account in your name. You deposit 400,000 euros. You make a fixed term deposit for 5 years, and you are being granted a golden visa immediately. The same as if you buy a property. What is the asset? The asset is that you can, first of all, you have capital guarantee. Your money are with a European bank. In the Schengen, there are 4 systemic banks in Greece. There is no problem of bankruptcy. There is no problem that the bank will disappear. So your money is secure. And not only your money is secure, your way out is guaranteed, because whenever you want, you can cancel the deposit. You can take your money. You can walk away. You will lose your golden visa unless within 2 months from the time you have cancelled the fixed term deposit, you buy a property of 250. What is the best recipe, let's put it that way, the best advice? You want to see the markets. You don't know the market. You don't want to be fooled by a promoter who is selling ready-made properties with that do not cost 250. They will cost 150, 180, and if you go in the market, you will not be able to sell it. You open the bank account in Greece, you put up your 400,000, you are not going to lose them. You get your residence permit, and whenever you feel comfortable and you find the good occasion, you can cancel the deposit and convert your monetary golden visa to a golden visa on real estate. Golden visa has been very successful. There have been more than 10,000 now golden visas issued, golden visa applications. And it is the best, it is the most cost-effective golden visa. It can give you Greek citizenship after 7 years on the basis of certain requirements. Now, if you don't want to put money in Greece, a lot of money, and you just want to put 100,000 or 150,000, depending your family status. There is the FIP. The FIP is, again, you block some money in Greece and you can get a 2-year residence permit. The only drawback for this program is that you need to have 6 months presence in Greece in order to renew it. This is a program that has been extensively been used by Russian people, and there are many Russians who are currently in Greece under the FIP program and who extend it. Just to make more clear the situation, you need to show to the tax authority, to the administration, and to the consular authorities who give you the first visa to come to Greece, that you have sufficient income. And what is sufficient income as per the Greek law? It is 2,000 euros per month from a passive source. That is rent, fixed term deposit, or pension. If you don't have that, then we advise the client to open a bank account and put the money in Greece so that he shows his financial capability. For ultra high net worth individuals now, the solution, and we have already done 3 with Caribbean passports in Greece, it's the Greek non-dom. What is the regime? The regime is that you start to do a project, or you start to do an investment in Greece, the value of which should be minimum 500,000. That is to say, purchase of a property, capital injection in a company. You show the proof that you are going to do it. You pay 100,000 per year flat rate tax to the administration. And if you are followed by dependents, you add 20,000 per dependent, and you are taxed in Greece on your worldwide income. We had cases of individual entrepreneurs from the Russian Federation, and there is a possibility to have the double taxation treaty between Greece and Russia to apply even for them. So the non-dom gives you unrestricted access to the European Union and unrestricted access to Greece, and it can be coupled with your Dominica passport or even with your Russian passport. And the last program that we can provide to the agents and to their clients is a corporate solution in Greece that will give your client the possibility to have a residence permit for 2 years coupled with a work permit. European work permits are can be transferred to any European country after 18 months. That is to say, you can establish your company in Greece and you can migrate after to another European country. So this is the end of my presentation, and the joint presentation for Greece and Dominica, and how you can combine both of them. I shall be very happy to receive your questions if there are any.
Yes, many thanks for your presentation. There are many people in former Soviet republics who love Greece, who spend a lot of time in Greece. And
yes, I see the 4K. I see that Vlad is very active.
Yes, you have questions there, and there is one more question I would like to ask right now.
So the approximately is about 1%, the interest rates.
The interest, okay.
But what people have to understand is that by doing the deposit, they have zero risk and availability of their capital at the first demand. There is the only thing is that they have to be conscious that they will not have a golden visa unless they swap to property.
Christos, could you please tell us how much time should the applicant live in Greece in order to become citizen, to get citizenship?
For the golden visa, you cannot even step in Greece after your biometrics. For the FIP, you have to spend the 6 months per calendar year. For the non-DOM, there is no restriction. For the corporate structures, you need 6 months presence. And for the citizenship, you have to have 7 years of residence permit and an effective residence in Greece 5 years out of the 7 years, along with speaking with Greek, the Greek language. So I can give you another parameter that I have seen from many Russians in Greece, is that they continue to work in the Russian Federation, but the family is in Greece and the family goes to school here. So the children that are born in Greece from one parent who is legally residing in Greece, when they arrive at the 18 year of age, they have their autonomous right to apply for Greek citizenship. That's to say, irrespective of their parents, the child, only by the fact that he was born in Greece and went to a Greek school, it can be a Greek. So this is what I want to conclude, that there is no European program now for citizenship. Greece is the only possibility for, combined with Dominica, is the possibility to have immediately a passport that gives you international mobility and the possibility to arrive to get a European passport at the end.
Okay, Christos, thank you very much for your presentation. Thanks.
Thank you.